There is a possibility, there is always a possibility that a person can be mentally ill. You never really see the signs as signs.
When I was 12, 13 years old, I started experiencing panic anxiety attacks, which eventually led to bouts of depression. So I was diagnosed with what they call the major depressive disorder, MDD. We grew up in a broken home. My dad and my mom separated when I was 3 years old. As a kid, I was okay, but hitting my adolescent years, apparently all those things combined, the searching for a father figure, the adolescence, all the hormones changing, the academic stresses, the stress I put on myself, and the hereditary condition that I had. And that was the first trigger.
It is very difficult, I guess, for members of the family, especially the parents, to understand that even if they have given everything to make their child happy, their child can be sad or anxious or feel that they're not worth it. And it's not the parents' fault. It's an illness.
There's no magic pill. There's no, you know, one magic drug that you can say to your parents or your doctor, please cure me. There's no cure for conditions like these. You have to find a way to take charge and find that balance.
So now there really is a need to talk about it, just so we're aware that it can happen to any age, to young people, to old people, to rich people, to poor people.
In the conversation and the context of giving hope and inspiration, because there are people out there like me, and that was my goal. I wanted to come out and share my story, and in the hope that others would share their stories as well.
Survivors of suicide or loss because of suicide is a very complicated grief. It has been a journey and it is not over, but talking about it helps, really.
The title of the whole event is called Will You Still Love Me?
It's on July 14. There's going to be music and dancing, and there's going to be exhibits, installations. There's going to be improvisations. There's going to be a forum, poetry reading, spoken word.
And to combine the powers of what You Will Be Alright has done in terms of getting awareness and what Julia's story, which will never be forgotten, and this will be everybody's way of honoring Julia even more.
It's about asking people if they love us even if we are broken, and being answered hopefully yes. Because if you're answered yes when you ask, will you still love me, then you will have the courage and hope to live even if you have depression or anxiety.
If anybody out there is going through any mental health issues, mental health challenges, it could be you, someone you know, someone you love, the most important thing is to reach out and seek help.
For those parents who think that it's possible, because it is possible, that your child might have mental issues, put down your gadget, go online, and read up on it. And then observe your child. Look at your child.
This is a serious thing. This is an understood illness. We have to understand that this is something that can be treated, something we can live with, something we can survive, something we can thrive with. Understand that people love you, love yourself, accept yourself. And when you know that, and you know that there's help that's out there, you will be all right.
We're here for you. And we want to tell you that you matter and you should never give up.